Happy birthday to me. Today I'm 25, 19th of April, and in this video I'm going to run you through five things that I've learned in my short 25 years on this planet. Now, objectively, against the average person for my age, I've achieved a significant amount. I'm aware of that. Not to be narcissistic or to say, oh, look at how much money I make. Look at my watch. It cost me $30. Look at my watch, look at my car, look at my lifestyle. I'm so much better than you. If you've been watching me for any period of time, you know that I don't care. But objectively, against the average person for my age, I've achieved an awful lot. And in this video, I'm going to run you through five things that I've learned, lessons that took me 7 years in business. So I started when I was 18, more, 17, 18. But I started 7 years ago, and now I'm a multimillionaire. I make hundreds of thousands of dollars every single month, and I don't have to do much work to sustain that level of wealth. And there's five key things that, if you understand, make achieving that significantly easier. Now, this is by no means the five things you need to know. You need to know a lot. But these are five things that I've learned, and I thought, do you know what? If 18-year-old me knew these or had the mental comprehension mechanism to digest them and understand them earlier on, I'd be able to achieve what I achieved significantly faster. So I'm going to tell you these things, and I'm going to tell you, like, when I was 18, I was 19, watching YouTubers talk about these things they learned. You're not going to truly understand these ideas. You'll understand them, and you'll know what they mean, but something will have to happen to you, or you'll have to have experience that affirms the knowledge. Okay, so you can understand these things and get to grips with them, but it's not until things happen to you that you really think, oh, so that's what Charlie was talking about. Because people make this common mistake of learning knowledge, where they learn the knowledge, they learn the idea, and then it kind of just stows away. It's really, you need to understand the idea, let something happen to you, and then you'll sort of think, holy mother of God, that weird guy that looks like Vitalik with a birthmark was somehow right, okay? So I'm 25 today. I'm sure that, you know, when I'm 30, when I'm 35, I'll learn more stuff and my knowledge and my experience levels will be significantly greater. But for now, take everything I say with a pinch of salt, because I might be wrong, but this has served me quite well, okay? The number one thing I think that I've learned is that any problem can be solved. I do think that's probably the main thing I've learned. Obviously, you have a goal, you have a desire. If this is where you are now and this is where you want to be, right, we'll use my fists here, don't get too intimidated. This is where you are, this is where you want to be, right? And there's a gap between these two points. That gap is basically time. But realistically, in order for you to get where you want from where you are, you just have to solve a series of problems. That's really all business is it's problem solving, it's problem solving, it's problem solving. And what eventually happens if you solve enough problems is you have the problem I have now, where you have a load of money and you don't know what to do with it, and you have too much time and you haven't got enough work to do. Right, so those are the two problems I now face, is I have too much money, and this is not, once again, I know it sounds like this weird ego play, it's not a power move, I'm not trying to do anything here, I'm just being honest with you. The two problems I face right now is having too much time and not knowing where I should put my time because I haven't got much work to do anymore. There's more to do, but I'll explain that another day. Too much time and having a bunch of money and not knowing what to do with it and what's best and where to invest it. Those are the two problems I'm tackling with. Those two problems are arguably the most desirable problems to have for any business owner, right? The problem of I've got too much time, I've got too much money, right? Things that most people never ever have too much of. And I'm tackling those, but in order to build to that level, you have to solve other problems, right? So any problem can be solved. The only thing is that you can only solve a problem if you are capable of solving it. And the good thing is that you're malleable, right? You're adaptable. You can become capable. So if the problem you're solving right now in your business is sales, I can't get any deals. The great news is that you can solve it because other people have solved it. You just have to become someone else. So in order for you to solve problems, you have to change and shift your identity. You have to be like a shapeshifter, a chameleon sort of thing. So that's number one. Any problem can be solved. I truly believe that. I think that if it's within the laws of nature and physics and human nature, and the laws of the universe, then it can be solved. So that's number one. So I share it. Now, number two is similar to what I just mentioned there, but you don't achieve goals, you achieve characters. So if you want to achieve a certain status in life, if you have a desired outcome, if you want to make $10,000 a month, $100,000 a month, if you want to be a billionaire, if you want to, whatever you want, right, comes as a result of you being the person that can achieve it. So if you want to make 10 grand a month, don't try to make 10 grand a month. Try to become the person that can easily make that happen, and it will. So when it comes to goals, you have to understand the stoic belief of what is and isn't in your control. So you have externals. Levels of income, for example, we'll take money because it's an easy arbitrary example. Levels of income, they are external. You can't control how much you make, right? To a degree, you can kind of, but there's an argument philosophically there, but mostly you can. What you can control is the input, who you are, how much you work, how many hours you put in, how much you focus, how many distractions you get rid of, right? So when I'm looking at goals and stuff, if I want to be a billionaire, my goal isn't to be a billionaire in the sense that, you know, I want to make $1 billion or whatever. My goal is to become the person that can be a billionaire. So when I say I want to be a billionaire, I don't mean it in the sense that, like, I want the billion. I want to be the person that can make the billion, because I know that by doing that, which is directly in my control because I can change myself, the billion will come. I'm hoping it doesn't make sense. Number three, and this is one that you probably don't want to hear. Go where the most pain is, right? Now, I'm not advocating for some sort of masochistic behavior here, right? Whatever the hell that means. But in business, you must face resistance and pain. Imagine you've got this trifecta of psychology. You've got pain, you've got effort, and you've got resistance. Pain manifests when resistance meets effort. So let me explain this. So it's a really important lesson in psychology that I've learned. So there are things you need to do to achieve your goal. There are causes, because all success is cause and effect. You do something, the result happens with a bit of latency and a lapse of time. There are things that you must do in order to achieve your goal. And the funny thing about life is that for some reason, and I know why, but I'll go into it another day because it'll take too long to explain. But for some reason, if what you want to achieve, let's say that you need to send 100 cold emails a day to achieve what you want, you're gonna sweat and hate doing those 100 emails a day, right? And so what happens is pain, right? The psychological pain, I'm not talking about physical pain here. When I say go where the most pain is, I don't mean go and like fucking lay on a bed of nails and like, you know, smack yourself 5 times a day. I don't mean it like that. I mean psychological pain that comes as a result of doing hard work, right? There's something you need to do and you don't want to do it. That is called resistance. It exists for a reason. In fact, if you want to understand the reason, type in trial by fire Charlie Morgan, or type in this video will make or break your SMMA Charlie Morgan. It's a 2.5 hour video where I explain exactly why this works. Like I said, I'm not going to do it now because it'll take too long. So resistance, there's something you must do but you don't want to do it. That is resistance. Effort is the second thing in the equation. Effort is basically your psychological will forcing you to do something you don't want to do. Pain is the thing that happens when resistance meets effort, and the more pain you experience as a result of those two things marrying, the more successful you will be. That is the truth. When you look at someone who's been successful, you know, it's almost kind of like you can look at their, don't look at their bank account or how much money they make, look at how much pain they've put themselves through. Because their bank account and how much money they make is almost always a mirror reflection of how much pain they put themselves through. Go where the pain is. Go where you feel resistance. Put effort into resistance and sit in the pain. And that is, look, it's a very sort of archetypal by nature. We understand as humans that suffering is the key to meaning, right? And the suffering is the meaning, is the means to accomplishment. So go where the pain is. If there's something you don't want to do, do it. And don't put it off till tomorrow, because that's just stupid. So I should probably correct that. Go where the most pain is today. If you do that every single day, then you will be successful. Because if you're looking at your business, you probably need to get clients. That's probably why you're struggling, right? You don't want to do it. You're a bit nervous. You're a bit anxious. That is resistance. Effort is your will. Meet the resistance with your will. Pain will manifest. It will be horrible and uncomfortable. But the longer you sit in that pain, the bigger your tolerance for pain becomes. The more action you can take, the more success you'll be able to achieve. Success is cause and effect, okay? That's all it is. Is it doing things that create the result you want to create? And if the only thing that holds you back from doing the things is resistance and it's pain, so you just need to sit with it. Number four. 99% of people are wrong. So this is something that I've learned. I've received advice from hundreds and hundreds of people in my time. Mentors, friends, family members, etc., etc. All of whom have had good intentions. People who love me, who care for me, who want to see me succeed, who have lent me their paradigm and knowledge or experience on the way they see the world and how I should tackle the problems I'm trying to solve. What I can say with confidence is that 99% of people who give you advice are wrong. Because 99% of people aren't where you want to be. So as a rule of thumb, you should never take advice from someone unless they are where you want to be. Now, caveat this. For example, my dad, my mum, my sister, my brother, people who I hold very fucking dearly, who I fucking love, they give me incredible advice because they know me. So for example, if my sister, she's a wonderful woman, I love her to bits, right? We're basically like best friends. If she gave me advice on how to run my business, I'd probably be like, oh, thanks, but I wouldn't listen to her because she's never run a business and she's never given me business advice. However, if I went to her and said, I've got this problem in my business, you know me really well, what mistake am I likely to make? She'd be able to tell me instantly, right? So there's a caveat to this where when I say 99% of people are wrong, there's people in your life that know you really well and give you very sound, accurate advice based on their knowledge of you. For example, my mum and my dad especially when it comes to finance and stuff. He knows me, he knows my situation, he gives me great advice and I follow it and it works. But there's instances where, you know, I see people who like start businesses because, and then one person in a random pub gives them an idea and then they go and run with it. And it felt like, you know, you have to just accept the fact that most people, even if they have good intentions, even if they have pure, honest, reasonable intention towards your life and want you to succeed, they're probably wrong. Because if they were right, if they were smart enough to do what you wanted to do, then they would have done it. So as a rule of thumb, if you're trying, like, for example, with health, right? I'm working with Mark Dharma, who is Sam Evans's and Ty Lopez's health coach. I trust him to give me advice on health. What I don't trust is some random person in the gym who's been working out for 3 months, who has watched a YouTube video and then they've... Do you get my point? Just be very careful with who you take advice from. Even me, critical thinking is important. Be able to filter information through. Number five, what you do today will be the result you achieve in 7 years' time. So like I said before, success is cause and effect, right? You do something today and you probably won't see the fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth order consequence of that for a long time. But let me tell you something. I started reading business books when I was about 15, 16 years old. You know, every day, ask anyone who used to know me, I would devour books like a demon. I would do courses, I'd do books, everything. I was obsessed. And that obsession didn't bear fruit really for probably about 5-6 years. And, you know, I was putting things into motion to become a millionaire or multimillionaire when I was, you know, 17, 18. And I only became a multimillionaire, or maybe, albeit 3 or 4 years ago, so it didn't take as long as maybe you'd expect. But just know that there is a big chasm of time between what you do now and what you do in the future. And this works on both sides of the coin. So if you do things that limit your goal and inhibit your ability to achieve your goal, then in years to come, you will pay the price of that idiocy. But if you do things now that help you achieve your goal, then you're obviously more likely to be successful. It's one of those things that's kind of hard to articulate. You have to live it, and the only way to live it is to give it time. But let me tell you this, if you read a book a week, as I did, for example, I think between the ages of like 17 to 19, I probably read like, I don't know, an easy like 150 books, 200 books, like a book a week, just solidly. And now I can make YouTube videos that are coherent, that are logical, concise, and backed with, you know, some level of knowledge. And the only reason, like, people ask me, like, Charlie, how do you, I mean, I'm not the most articulate person in the world, but I get questions from people on these YouTube videos, like, how do you sit down? Like, this video has been recorded in one take, which is me basically sitting in front of a camera and talking. I'm able to coherently articulate myself because I've read hundreds of books. And this YouTube channel generates me hundreds of appointments every single month, which makes me multi six figures a month in income. And that is in part largely because I read hundreds of books when I was 17. Does that make sense? Even if like the shit you do now is the shit, like is all the good shit happens in years to come. I just said I'm the most articulate person. So I'm articulate and then I just phrase it in that way. But I'm hoping you understand the point here. Present Charlie thanks past Charlie for his actions. And future Charlie will thank present Charlie for his actions as well. I'm going to leave you with one more point in closing. Number six is, if you can see it, you can have it. So if you can, like, you need to get really fucking crystal clear on exactly what you want your life to look like. Exactly. Define what you want. Define who you want to be. Define what you want to achieve. Define who you are or who you want to be in years to come and see it as clear as day. So you close your eyes and you visualize everything you want. For example, I've got the car that I want. I used to sit before I go to sleep every night. I would lie there and I would close my eyes and I would imagine my hands on the AMG sports steering wheel. And what I noticed on pictures of AMGs is like in the middle of the steering wheel at the top, there's like a sort of gap in the leather and a little rib, and then it goes around again. So I'd imagine like feeling around like the steering wheel and like the smell of the seats, and that's weird, I don't sniff seats, I promise, but the smell of the leather on the seats, right? I'd imagine the cold start of the car and the opening the exhaust, the clock and the wooden panel. Like, you have to just like imagine, like shut your eyes. And I used to close my eyes before I go to sleep and I'd like imagine the exact apartment I'm in now. I'd imagine like the taste of the coffee, I don't drink coffee anymore, but the taste of the tea or the coffee in the morning, and like opening the windows and the breeze from the city or from the countryside sort of hitting my face. And just like, you need to get as in the I don't want to use this word in a strange sense, but the most sensual visualization that you can possibly imagine. Get very, very clear on exactly what you want and what you want in your life and what you want to achieve. Just constantly see it over and over again, because what you need to start doing with your life is optimizing, where you have a goal, right? You have something up here that you want to achieve, whether it's in the beginning, it's hard to have the long sight of like 30, 40 years, but set yourself like a 5-year goal. By this point, I want to be doing this. And then like what you then start to do is all of your decisions and actions in your life are filtered through the question of, does this help me achieve my goal? And if the answer is yes, you do it. If the answer is no, you don't do it. And if the answer is yes, it does a fucking lot, then you do more of it. So when I was 18 years old and I knew I wanted to be a multimillionaire and have all this cool stuff, I'd ask myself like my primary goal, and then I'd be like, okay, so I've got the option this week. Do I read Letters from a Stoic by Seneca, or do I go out and party and drink? Okay, well, which one's more likely to have me be a multimillionaire by the time I'm 25? Oh, it's probably Letters from a Stoic by Seneca. So maybe let's read that. And it's the most important thing to understand above all of this. I'm saying this, there's lots of important stuff, but where you are right now is the sum of every single decision and action you've ever taken in your life. Everything you've ever done, every action, every decision, everything you've ever done has led up to this very moment right here. And so if you're not happy with your life and if you're not happy with your circumstances, that's your fault, my friend. Now, there's going to be shit that's happened to you, trauma, bad events, things that are outside of your control that may hinder your ability to achieve the level of success you want. But until you're willing to take responsibility for your life and admit that everything that happens to you is your fault, and everything, and your, you know, there's things that happen that are awful that aren't your fault, obviously, but like 90%, 95% of your life is your fault. What that means is you have this power of responsibility and you have this obligation, this moral obligation of life, which is fucking important. So make sure that you take responsibility. That's probably another thing. I know this has been a bit of a messy video, but those are the 6 things I've learned. Any problem can be solved. You don't achieve goals, you achieve characters. Go where the most pain is today and sit there for as long as you can. 99% of people are wrong. And what you do now unfolds in, you know, years to come. And obviously number 6 I just explained. So I hope this goes some way to helping you become more successful. If it does, you can subscribe and like and comment. If you run an agency or a coaching business and you need more clients, but you don't know how to get them, click the first link in the description. It's a sales page. It's going to get you to buy something, right? You don't have to click it. I don't mind. But if you are struggling with that, we can help you. I hope you have the most wonderful day, and happy birthday to me. Talk to you later.